Hello students, today we will go through IoT data analytics overview. So here they have explained four types of data analysis results. So here you can see in the diagram the types of data. So you have four types of data analysis results. One is descriptive, second is diagnostic, third is predictive, and fourth is prescriptive. So we will go through one by one. So first is descriptive. So here you can see in the diagram they have specified what is happening. So descriptive analysis tells you what is happening, okay, either at the present state or in the past. And they have given one example that a thermometer in a truck engine reports temperature values every second. Okay, from a descriptive analysis perspective, you can pull this data at any moment to gain insight into the current operating condition to the truck engine. So this thermometer will sense the values, and it will be it will produce result or values in every second, and you can pull that data whenever you want it. So if the temperature value is too high, then there may be a cooling problem, or the engine may be experiencing too much of load. So here you the thing is that the what is happening in the particular system is told in this descriptive analysis. Next is diagnostic. So diagnostic, you can see here in the box, they are telling it why did it happen, whatever the problem in the system, why that problem, particular problem occurred. So that you get to know in this diagnostic part. So when you are interested in the why, diagnostic data analysis can provide an answer. So again, they have continued the example of a temperature sensor in the truck engine. So so you can wonder why the truck engine failed. So here, using diagnostic analysis, you can see that the temperature of the engine was too high and the engine overheated. So this is the reason the engine failed. So by using this diagnostic analysis, you can you can determine why that particular problem occurred. Next is predictive. So predictive analysis aims to foretell problems or issues before they occur. As the word itself says, predictive, so we can predict what is going to happen. So here again they have taken an example with historical values of temperatures for the truck engine. Predictive analysis could provide an estimate on the remaining life of certain components in the engine. So by by getting the values day by day, you can just predict what is going to happen. If the engine is over heated too much, then you can tell, okay, this engine will work another 1 year, later on it will be it will fail. So this is the predictive analysis. Next is prescriptive. So here prescriptive analysis goes a step beyond predictive and recommends solution. So it's a continuation. For example, predictive is you just predict what is going to happen. In prescriptive, with that predictive, you just tell what is the solution for that particular problem. So here again the example is that a prescriptive analysis of the temperature data from a truck engine might calculate various alternatives to cost effectively maintain a truck. So this calculation could range from the cost necessary for frequent it will suggest solution. For example, how to maintain the truck engine, or how frequently the oil should be changed, and how to cooling maintenance system, how it should be installed. So all this comes in this prescriptive analysis. So here when you use predictive and prescriptive analysis, so they provide they increase the complexity, and the value they provide is much greater than the value from the descriptive and diagnosis. So here you can see in the graph that value of prescriptive and predictive analysis are high compared to diagnostic and descriptive analysis. Okay, so then next we will see what are the challenges, okay, of this data analytics. So the first one is that scaling problem. So as you all know, due to large number of objects in the network, it will be immersed in sending data, because of this sending and receiving data, relational databases can grow incredibly large very quickly. So this will result in performance issue. This is one of the problem or challenge in IoT data analytics. The second one is volatility of data. So what is volatile? Volatile is nothing but it should you if you change the system also, it should work properly. It should not, you know, cause any errors or such. So that is called as volatility. So whenever you have a relational database and during, you know, critical situation, if you change the design or schema from the beginning, so changing it will, you know, it will cause some problems, like it can slow or stop the database from operating. So due to lack of flexibility, revisions to the schema must, you know, it should be kept minimum. So you should not change, you know, the schema, you know, every now and then. So this will cause, so this is one more challenge you know, faced by IoT data analytics. So this is about challenges of IoT analysis and overview, that is four types of data analysis results. Okay, thank you.